Yes, by the title of this video, it is true. The future of Tier 2 is not competitive. Now, I took a look at RE7's newest video and I just was just furious in general at the end. I mean, not the end, but more like as the entire video. He just kind of portrays as how TF2 cannot survive if it is gonna stay casual and it should go competitive. I have major fucking issues with the overall message of his video. Just major issue. Number one, TF2 has survived for a while without any updates, but not because of the competitive scene or any type of way. It's because of the general silly, wacky, and chaotic mess that is TF2. Basically, it's one of his last kind of FPS genre where it's actually good, decent, and you could actually have fun without having to be a sweaty tribe fucking back. And the fact that these e-celebrities are trying to push the narrative that no, TF2 must go competitive if it's gonna survive for a while. We've been surviving for a while without having, like, we've been nearly, what, over 14, 13 years now, and we have shown that we could still grow a lot as a community. And do you know why we've been surviving long as a community? For this many years, where most games will die out at some point. Like, hell, even the newer games are basically dying out slowly already within, what, maybe a year or so? But TF2 has been surviving for a very long time. Because of the videos that have been made about it, TF2 lore, interesting weapons, etc, etc, etc. And for its lore, it's actually pretty funny concept within the lore itself. I mean, the game overall is just interesting, funny, wacky, just everything. And the gameplay kind of supports this too. I mean, for God's sakes, you could just rocket jump and then just hit a man with a shovel or meme spoon or whatever the fuck it calls. But still, do you know why TF2 still has a big major player base? Because TF2 has this unique build about it that makes you not only that it could make you feel competitive, but at the same time you play casually as you want. Even with the bad weapons that we have, we can still make use of it. We can still have fun with it. And that's what makes TF2 more unique than the other FPS genres that we have. It's fun, it's nice, and just basically it's easy, just relax. Now, I'm a very competitive player myself. I'm not like full sweaty try hard, but I do get the little tick inside me. Just kind of craves competition. However, I do want to relax as well. I just want to play around in the game. Hell, I could just be a funny goddamn fat man with a shotgun. Or just play any entire subclass. I mean, for God's sake, you could turn a demolition man into a fucking knight. I mean, do you know many games that has unique mechanics that, or many subclasses that people could, you know, mess around with? No, not much. In fact, I'm pretty sure TF2 is one of its kind that it could have many of these weapons, and to them it doesn't matter if it's competitively valid or not. It's still fun to use that. But look at the competitive scene on the TF2 side. They have stricter rules, they have banned weapons, etc, etc. Do you know why? It's because it's not competitively valid. I mean, for God's sakes, even the weapons that are allowed to use, people will be like, no, use stock, no, use this, use the meta. Really? Not every single one of us wants to go competitive. I mean, look at FaZe. At first, it was supposed to be the new way to play casual, but then it's like, oh, no, it's like kind of casual, but a bit more calm. And then it's just semi-calm altogether. Just know, guys, we shouldn't just stick to a competitive system to make this game survive. For years, it just has been surviving on its own with this, you know, chaotic, fun, wacky. And we shouldn't be. And these e-celebrities, I don't care how long they have been, they should not try to change something that has been surviving for a long time. And in fact, I made this video because of RE7's video about is TF2 getting too competitive. And what does he does at the end and in the title, he he conflicted, so he's asking the question that is TF2 getting more competitive, and then at the end he's basically saying no, but we should be more competitive if this game wants to survive. Stop it. No, we shouldn't be surviving on comp alone. We should be just surviving what we already had. And plus on the competitive side as well, do you remember on with the Meet Your Match update, it was trying to balance weapons that will help competitive players as well. But guess what happened? It was a big major disaster. I don't have to give you a history lesson about it. Just do some research. And plus, even if these weapons were to be catered to the comp community, most of them won't even fucking use them. What? I mean, seriously, when was the last time in the comp scene that you seen someone that used the Market Gardener as a tool? I mean, as a weapon? No, tell me. And no, don't count Lazy Purple's clip. I see you in the background, fucker. So the basic overall of this video is we should not be changing TF2 just because we wanted to make it more competitively valid. Not everybody is into that. Even people like me who enjoys the thrill of challenges and a bit of comp challenges, even I know when I just want to relax and lay back without having to be so sweaty try hard. So please guys, we should not be doing this shit. And for God's sakes, the e-celebrities who endorse of TF2 should be all around calm. Stop it, okay? All you're doing is just killing the game even more. I mean, we already have enough to deal with the bot crisis and everything. Cheaters, hackers, etc. No update. At least not right now. But do not try to push the narrative that the little vocal minority of the comp TF2 players should be in the mainstream. TF2 doesn't need to be in the mainstream, or does it need to be a big esports game? No, it does not. It has been surviving years without it, and I think it should just stay like that. So, yeah.